We are out here. We're working on the Q50.
So guys, today we are installing AMS downpipes
for the Infinity. Chrissy, I don't know who the fuck told you to get in here.
Don't not get an O2 socket because you're gonna break it.
Alright guys.
We took it out. Now you transfer to the new one.
Anyways, I just took off this whole cat right here. And this is the new one that data base is in fact putting the O2 thing on there. I just took this off. This is some pretty hard work, guys. We had to get screws from up here and from down there.
We did it.
We just need to put the little bolts on those holes so they can line up perfectly, and then we'll get to tightening.
Talk to them. Talk.
Yo, let me see a nut.
All right, he's placing a nut right here. This is basically the baby work.
This is what we need to remove, this monstrosity.
Let me start, right?
See, yo, clip. Putting in a little gasket.
Oh, fuck, that rust fell on my heart.
Look
at that. He hit
his head on the mirror.
No,
I didn't, bro.
What's going on?
Hi, guys. I'm here, too. Hi.
Can I get down here?
I'm going to come out real quick and just drop the jack on him.
Okay.
Just chop his head.
Yeah. We got a fresh car.
First round decapitation.
This downpipe finesse.
Can I even get through here?
Look at where he gets out, guys.
Smooth process.
All right, we basically got half the job done.
Yo, wait.
The next mod.
Stupid boys. Yeah, I don't even know what we just did, man. We are here working on the Infinity Q50. And as you guys can see, we installed a twin turbo in the 3.7 liter, guys.
These are the turbo law valves.
Let us know.
The air comes out here.
Really?
Takes it in,
from
here.
Oh,
comes out.
Work.
All the hot air goes out of this filter because it needs to clean the environment.
All right, guys, we installed the intakes. Are you guys about to cut them? Yo. Go rev it for the shoe boys. Nice.
It's a little weak. Exhaust coming in soon.
Exhaust is here.
It is
we
here.
Cannot coordinate a day for all of us to be off. I got the jack stands ready. I got two of them in my house, two of them in the doorman.
I could install the exhaust right now.
Let's go! Fuck Jovi.
Now he's about to suck my meat like that, just like that. He does it just like that.
The next mod.
Welcome back, Sheepa boys. Welcome back to working on the Q. At this current moment, Daniel and Ani are removing the rear diffuser because we are installing a brand new bad boy.
Shut up, don't say it's fake, bro.
Look at this. Look at the real carbon, guys.
Wow. That's not real carbon.
There's a light there. They're not. Oh, we took it off. You guys don't know how the other one looks like. But now there's a light and it's carbony. Before installing the diffuser,
bro, this is dead
you
ass.
Have to clean the surface white. With alcohol or fucking water.
No, we have alcohol.
That's alcohol, guys. Yep. That's alcohol. Bro, what is this rice, my guy?
AMS downpipes, we installed them.
Mans gets downpipes, doesn't even know how to fucking act.
No, we installed it ourselves too. You know how we do.
Oh my
god. Hold the brake. Look how much that brake. Look how much that flashes. It flashes like 4 times more than ours.
What the hell? Hit the brakes. Hold them. Alright, as you can see.
See how it doesn't flash 30 times anymore?
It doesn't flash anymore.
I spliced the red wire into the white wire, so whenever the red wire hits, it doesn't go straight to the white wire down, it goes to the white wire.
Honestly, I still don't understand how you fucking did it, even though I'm here. Sorry. I'm sorry, guys, if you don't understand that. You guys have to figure out yourself somehow.
The next mod.
Welcome back to another episode.
Levis K.
Levis Big K, you know what I mean? Welcome back, Chris. Welcome back to another episode. You haven't seen him in a minute, guys. This man, Daniel, is installing aftermarket LED signals. Oh, look at them. Sequentials, and you got the carbon fiber fin Q50 mirror caps, my shit, and now we're doing mirror number two. I'm sorry I didn't record.
Right,
I just
there.
Came. These idiots didn't
see
fucking
this?
Record. So first thing you gotta do is take off the door panel. Where are the screws for the door panels?
In my pockets.
And okay, but where do you access them? Like which ones do you have to take off first?
If you take a look over here, there's one in here.
There's a screw in there.
And there's one up there.
There's a screw up
that's,
there.
That was like right here.
That
and that's it. And just yank
there.
It out.
Woo! Honey, what are you doing?
Well, I'm just fixing up this tape real quick.
Oh, you're fucking boring. So this is the stock mirror cover, and these are the stock signals. Aftermarket and the stock.
Yo, this shit works.
Yeah, but I don't want this.
installed mirror number two. Mirror number one done, obviously. And now we got number two on. Let's get it.
All right, guys. We'll see you guys later.
See you on the next day. Bye.
The next mod.
Yeah, tips, yo.
Yeah, I don't know how it's gonna.
What you got there, Clevis?
I'm fisting the tip.
Yo, yo, yo! Welcome back to another episode, Quizzy But Boys. Today we're gonna be installing the exhaust. Look at that exhaust tip. Wow.
This is our first time installing exhaust. It's gonna be a learning process, but I think we could still do it.
Sheep boys can do anything.
Sheep boys, yo, sheep boys can do anything they want. Follow us on TikTok. Down in the link below.
Clevis right now is.
I'm taking off the muffler.
Is removing the muffler, and we have to do that on the other side. We unthreaded all the bolts for the muffler. Time to remove it.
You just pull it.
Oh, God. Just
pull, pull it from the pipe, from here.
Pull it from this jar. Oh, it just dropped. Next step, remove the resonator, which is this thing.
Oh, it's on.
The bolts are right there.
Right,
and there's gonna be one on the other side, I believe.
Yes.
Yeah, there is. We got rid of bolt number one. Now we're doing bolt number two right here.
Get in.
Now that we removed this one and this one over there on that side, time to remove this one in the middle.
Yeah.
And then this whole white pipe is gonna fall out. Just got rid of the white pipe. Pulled off the mid pipe. Let's get a start with no exhaust.
This is literally just down.
Now that the whole exhaust has been removed, we have to put in this piece for
the whole mid pipe connecting
for this?
to the resonators.
That's why this shit is stopping.
These guys already installed it. Sorry, guys, I didn't film.
Oh, I guess the back.
And then we're gonna get the other pipes and then the tips, and then we're done.
All right, guys, I got one resonator in right here. Daniel's about to get the other one in, and then we're gonna put the rest of the pipe. And then all we need is the pipe for the muffler and the tips, and that's it, basically.
Resonator. Number two installed.
We need a new,
just when we were about to finish.
We don't think we have a same.
He needs
size
to tie in the last tip, ayo. And he broke the nut. This guy only has to run with one tip.
Ayo.
But you know, it makes it look like a single exit Q50, so it kind of makes it look like a sleeper. Cold start.
Hope y'all enjoyed today's video. I'll see you guys in the next mod. And
top of the morning to you, ladies.
I'm so sorry.
Anyways, I hope y'all enjoyed today's mod. I'll catch you guys on the next mod. See ya.
This is the inside cabin sound.
Downshift.
It's a little louder than we expected, but
it's way louder than we expected. That's just crazy.
I mean, I guess it's a live and learn. I guess it's a process where you just like, since you're not used to exhaust, you just like start getting used to it over time. Like, we're very new to exhaust. This is our first exhaust we installed. Third gear. Fourth gear, you can't even hear it at all.
Fourth gear at 30 miles per hour, that's crazy.
But once you hit those like lower gears and be like, like that's the whole time. It's not like, I mean, that's what you expect. Second gear. You hear like drrrr.
The next mod.
Yo, what's going on, sheep? Boys, don't have to zoom in on my face. Get away from me. Hey, welcome back to a new mod, a new day.
So he'd exchange it, burger tuning.
Shut the fuck up. So as I was rudely interrupted, today we're gonna be installing a heat exchanger.
You were never here for any of the mods. Shut up. Get the fuck
out. I was in the
most. He's slaving
mods
at work, guy.
And we're putting a heat exchanger. You might be asking, why the hell are you installing a heat exchanger on a stock 3.0, bro? You have a surprise later on in this video. And we're gonna show you why we're gonna install this dumbass heat exchanger. We've never done it before.
Here's a little hint. Burger Motorsport.
We've never done this before, and it's gonna be a new little mod that is gonna check off our bucket list.
Now Daniel is taking off the bumper.
Yeah! All right, guys, the front bumper has been deleted.
By stupid boys.
It's right there. I know. Don't cut our ass. There's no rags on the bottom. We don't care, okay?
He's getting a new full body kit.
No, he's not. But
I want to do it.
This is the oil cooler thing. Oh God, I don't know what he's doing. He's removing the bolts. He's taking off the crash bar, I guess, so we can get access to this.
We gotta take off his computer. Oh, you don't have one on your side?
Taking off the crash bar, and this little piece also comes down as well. Whatever that is, I don't know what that is. Let me know down in the comments below what that is. Oil cooler getting removed.
There's a clip behind it.
Temporarily, obviously. It was right there, now it's this way.
Yes, sir. Heat exchanger now removed.
Old and new.
On the thickness as well.
Look at the thickness of this. This is like my finger, and this one is like a whole freaking hand, bruh. Jesus. So now the new heat exchanger is installed, but it hasn't been bolted on yet. We are about to do that, and we have to connect the hose lines. Now the bolts have been tightened. Ooh. So we had to make a new hole on the bottom over here because
this was a little misaligned.
Because the OEM holes would not align with the brackets over here, so we had to make a new hole. The line was just installed on this side. This is the new tube that comes with the little kit, and now he's trying to.
Wait, don't you need this
on the? Push it in.
New clamp, right?
We are now installing this side's hose.
We'll see.
And we have to.
Hopefully, this shit actually fits. Right.
Clamp it out with the hose clamp, and then I don't know what happens next. The oil cooler used to be down there.
Oh, wait, this just comes out like this, I think.
Oil cooler used to be down there, but it doesn't fit because this is too big now, so it has to go on top over here, this section. He's trying to instructions say that you have to open it up.
Are you sure?
So it can fit.
This does not look like it comes off, bro.
Yeah, it does.
Because this shit gets in the way. This stuff gets in the way, so we have to like cut it like, and then make it like work. You know what I mean? All right, so that's a plastic piece for the oil cooler, and now look how small it is. It doesn't have like the plastics on it. Now we're gonna try test fit it, and hopefully it works. Okay, now the oil cooler is on top, all secured in place. Now we're gonna get these lines and then source them on top.
Oh, the oil just
and on the bottom. This guy's having so much trouble opening the thing, right, guys?
Facts.
Yeah, yo, look. Oh, we're gonna refill the car and with the coolant.
Hi, guys. So there's wind. So look at our wind covering techniques.
Man, you I poured the motherfucking thing. Stop looking at the camera, bitch.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Why are you, yo?
I don't have a steady hand.
Oh, my. Dumbass.
Oh, can you slow down, bro?
Dude, I'm not helping you, bro.
Alright, let's start up the car. So this is what it looks like. It looks pretty nice. The car is on. We don't see any leaks right now. It's been on for like 5 minutes. You know, we filled up the coolant. It's pretty up high right now, above the fill line, but that's alright. There's no way we can actually show you guys how this works because honestly, I don't even know. Putting back the front bumper on, and I think we're done. Hope you guys enjoyed this mod list, and hope you guys learned something new because we definitely did. Isn't that right, guys?
Yeah, very right.
Someone unenthusiastic, but yeah, anyways, I'll catch you guys on the next mod. See ya.
The next mod.
Yo, what's going on, Sheepa boys? Welcome back to another mod, another day. And today, we're going to be installing a front lip to the car. Before, there used to be a front lip, but we removed it just because Daniel was tired of the old black plastic lip, and now he's upgrading to a genuine carbon fiber one. It's a three-piece lip, and it's gonna be a very easy process because we've done this a few times. And yeah, let's get back to the installation. This is what the splitter looks like on the floor. Let's get a closer look at this real carbon. My goodness. Oh yeah, look
that's
at
how
the back.
You know that.
Yeah,
legit.
That's how you know it's okay.
That's how you know that shit's legit.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the front splitter all installed. It's kind of the same exact style as the old one, but he just wanted to get carbon because we all know carbon is always better. Hope you guys enjoyed this mod, and we're gonna be coming back to you with even a better mod next time. Welcome back, guys, to another day, another mod, and today we're gonna be installing some sport rotors, some brake rotors. Let me show you what it looks like. Here you go, we got them black rear fucking rotors. They are from Brake Performance. I don't know what the hell this shit is. But yeah, these are only for the rears. These two rotors, there's two rotors in here. The reason why they're black is because they have a coat, a protective coat.
Zinc,
and once
zinc.
They have zinc on them, and once the brakes press on the rotor, then the blackness disappears.
Do it.
All right, my friends, we took off the wheel. Now we are loosening one of the caliper bolts. Okay, so just have to take off the rotor and the caliper, and then we install the new rotors and install the caliper back on the place, and then we're good. Both brakes have been removed, only one brake actually, and now Clovis is installing the brake onto the lugs. The rotors are now installed. Now he has to tie in the caliper to the rotor.
That's really my favorite thing of the car.
And on the other side, Ani's also tightening the caliper on the rotor. Alright guys, oh my god, don't look at the curb rash, I'm sorry. But look at the new rotors, they're gonna look a little bit better once we ride them a little bit longer. Hey yo, this side is done with, and so is this side.
The next mod.
Alright Sheba Boys fam, you guys can see we got all the wheels right now in this joint. Check these out, yo, these are up for sale, who wants these? We got all the wheels right now. We got this drop. Yo, get off the phone. We're about to install the JB4. We got this put up. We got this through the firewall, this cable right here. Now we're about to install the unit. And then we're going to go give it a test drive while Daniel drops me off. It's going to be fire. And we're about to install this whole bad boy right now, real quick. Right now, we got this JB4 unit out of the actual packaging. And that's just to install this. So we gotta install this. This is the Bluetooth module. And this is gonna go into the car. You put in the JB4. You put in the Bluetooth module right here. You connect it to here, which we already did. You put it through the firewall. Connect the JB4. That's it. Pretty easy install.
Alright guys, you guys can't really see us right now. We got the JB4 installed. We got Daniel over here trying to check out the app settings. Oh. Yes, sir. No, it's not on. See the RPMs jumping.
Building is mad high, bro.
I'm not gonna lie, bro. I'm trying to fuck the shit out of you on the one. Kill me on the block, block, babe, block, babe. What? Kill me on the block, block, babe. Bitch. 32 shot, Glock, babe, Glock, babe. What? 32 shot, Glock, babe.